डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजियोलॉजी, कोऑर्डिनेटर सेंटर फॉर योगा एंड एक्सरसाइज साइंस, वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर द टुडेज इनॉगरल फंक्शन ऑफ एडवांस सेंटर ऑफ योगा फॉर कार्डियक प्रिवेंशन एंड रिहेबिलिटेशन बाय प्रेइंग विघ्नहर्ता लॉर्ड गणेशा। वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभा, निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकारेषु सर्वदा। नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट डॉक्टर सुमंगला पाटिल, हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजियोलॉजी, टू वेलकम द गैदरिंग।
A very good morning and suprabhata to all. It's my honor to welcome you all for the auspicious day of inauguration of Advanced Center of Yoga for Cardiac Prevention and Rehabilitation under Center of Yoga and Exercise Science, Department of Physiology, BLDE, deemed to be University, Sri B.M. Patil Medical College. So I extend my hearty welcome to Dr. M.B. Patil, sir, Honorable Vice Chancellor, BLD deemed to be University. Welcome, sir. I also extend my warm welcome to Dr. Ishwar V. Basavreddy, Director of Murarji Desai National Institute of Yoga. Welcome, sir. I also welcome our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. M.S. Biradar, sir, and Dr. Arvind V. Patil, sir, Dean Faculty of Medicine, who is presiding the function today. I extend my warm welcome to all the heads of the department and faculty of BLD deemed to be University and the faculty of entire Murarji Desai National Institute of Yoga and Center, New Delhi. Welcome you all who have joined virtually to this program, and also my dear students who have joined virtually for the inauguration of this center. Welcome you all. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for the welcoming address. Now we'll have a brief introduction about the Advanced Center of Yoga for Cardiac Prevention and Rehabilitation. Before that, I want to give introduction about our center, that is Center for Yoga and Exercise Science. Our university, which is situated in the backward region of North Karnataka, being situated, but our university is it is working a lot to help to maintain as a university to maintain health, harmony and happiness within the community. So we are to integrate the alternate medicine with the modern medicine to give overall health to the to maintain, like as World Health Organization has defined, health is a balance between physical, psychological, social and spiritual. So we are, as a university, we are trying to maintain to give all the aspects of health to whole community. And also we are proud so that our center is recognized by the Murarji Desai National Institute of Yoga Science. So we are proud for that. And also previously Dr. Satish Patil sir, who was a part of our yoga center, has worked extensively in the field of yoga, and our work has been recognized by the CSIR, and we have so many publications in the field of yoga, and so many recognitions also we have. So with that, I introduce Advanced Center of Yoga for Cardiac Prevention and Rehabilitation. The vision of Advanced Center of Yoga for Cardiac Prevention and Rehabilitation is to have joint research projects on cardiac patients with yoga protocols for postgraduate students and PhD students between our BLD deemed to be University and Murarji Desai National Institute of Yoga. With that, also we have to have therapeutic and clinical research projects with clinical departments of institute to conduct various cardiac rehabilitation and medical camps, workshops, to create awareness of yoga at various sub-centers and taluka places. And also, we are going to exchange faculty and students for research and therapeutic purpose. To start, also we are introducing academic degree and diploma courses with Morarji Desai National Institute of Yoga. Hence, this center aims to provide health, harmony, and happiness for the community of this part of the Karnataka. Thank you so much. Now I request Dr. Pallavi Kante, Assistant Professor, Department of Physiology, to introduce guests.
Thank you, Dr. Jyoti. A very pleasant morning. I am happy to introduce our chief guest, Honorable Chancellor Dr. M.B. Patil, sir. Sir has graduated with BE Civil Engineer and he is a firm believer in quality education. He has visited reputed institutes across the world with a view to adopt best practices which enhance the quality of education imparted in our institutes. In his political career, Sir got elected as MLA 5 times and Member of Parliament in 1999. In year 2013, elected as a MLA and had been a Cabinet Minister of Water Resources and also Home Minister in 2019, Government of Karnataka. He has emerged as a popular leader of farmers and masses. His recent movement for bringing Krishna water to the parched villages of Vijayapura district will remain in the memory of people of this region in the years to come. This unique massive effort has drawn the attention of entire nation. He has been aptly called modern Bhagiratha. Dr. M.B. Patil, sir, is spearheading a popular movement called Koti Vriksha Abhiyana, where he is planting 1 crore saplings in and around Vijayapura. Sir has been awarded with Basava Shanti Award, Shri Mahanta Award, and Shri B.D. Jetty Award in the year 2018 and many other awards. In recognition of his contribution to the field of education and social service, D.Y. Patil, Deemed to be University, Kolhapur, conferred honorary doctorate on 17 March 2015. In brief, Dr. M.B. Patil, sir, is carrying a great legacy of more than 100 years old education organization with a great responsibility. Here I present Dr. M.B. Patil, sir. Sir, thank you very much for connecting with us virtually.
The pleasure.
Now I would like to take this an opportunity to introduce today's guest of honor, Dr. Ishwar Basavareddy. Sir is the director of Morarji Desai National Institute of Yoga, Ministry of Ayush, Government of India, New Delhi for the last 16 years. He is also having the additional charge of advisor, Yoga and Naturopathy, Ministry of Ayush, Government of India. He is the head of Institute Yoga Certification Board, Ministry of Ayush, Government of India. Also a project director, WHOCC, Traditional Medicine in Yoga. He is also the president of National Yogasana Sports Federation and senior vice president of International Yogasana Sports Federation, member governing council of Indian Yoga Association and many other government and non-government organization. Dr. Basavareddy, having done MSc in physics, MA in philosophy, PhD in yoga philosophy, and also has got 2 diplomas to his credit. He has more than 32 years of experience in yoga education, training, therapy, and research. He is one of the eminent yoga masters of India and instrumental in bringing common yoga protocol for International Day of Yoga, which is being practiced by more than 200 million people across the globe. He was the master of ceremony, giving yoga instructions to more than 40,000 people, including Honorable Prime Minister of India at Rajpath, New Delhi, which went on to create 2 Guinness World Records. He was also the master of ceremony of International Yoga Day celebrations at Lucknow, Dehradun, Ranchi. Several initiatives have been taken up under his stewardship to propagate and to promote yoga across the country and abroad. Sir, here I present Dr. Ishwar Basavareddy, sir. Sir, thank you for connecting with us virtually. It is my privilege to introduce today's guest of honor, Professor Dr. M.S. Biradar, Honorable Vice Chancellor of BLD Deemed to be University, Vijayapura, Karnataka. Sir did his MD with gold medal in general medicine and entirely devoted himself for medical teaching, research, and administrations. Professor Dr. Biradar's iconic stature as a teacher and physician makes him a role model and authority in any discipline of medical sciences. His expertise in the area of medical education redefines the teaching in medicines as equality and diversity, work-based learning, mainly from bench to bedside, concept of high-impact basic sciences research and its application into clinical medicine. Sir has also immensely contributed in the area of medical research, ethics, and practices through his numerous publications, including books and book chapters. For his immense contribution in the field of medical administration, the Physiological Society of India conferred him a Professor K. Raghottam Rao Oration in the year 2016. Professor Biradar, sir, is also visiting professor at Tulane University School of Medicine, New Orleans, USA. Here I present our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. M.S. Biradar, sir. Now I request Dr. Sumangla Patil to present a bouquet to VC, sir. Thank you, ma'am. I feel immensely proud to introduce our today's president of function, Dr. Arvind Patil, Dean Faculty of Medicine, Shri B.M. Patil Medical College, Hospital and Research Center, Vijaypur. Sir did his MS in General Surgery from JN Medical College, Belgaum, Dharwad. He is known for his extraordinary commitments to academic fraternity and students by expanding students' opportunity, catalyzing academic innovation, and encouraging universities' civic engagement and service to society. As a head of the institution, Dr. Arvind Patil advances the university's mission towards excellence in teaching, research, and public services, and fostering collaboration across many national and international institutions with importance. Under his valuable leadership and with the guidance, enhanced the quality of medical education for students with inclusive experience, professionalism blended with flavor of internationalism. His constant encouragement to faculty members for taking up research in critical fields of multidisciplinary thirst area is definitively creating BLD University and a universal center of scholarship. Sir has awarded with Achievers of Karnataka by Vijay Karnataka for his outstanding contribution in the field of health sector in the year 2018. Here I present Dr. Arvind Patil, sir. Now I request Dr. Jyoti to present a bouquet to Arvind Patil, sir. Thank you, Dr. Jyoti. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much, Dr. Pallavi Kante. Now it is the time to light the lamp. Now I request all the dignitaries on the dais and all of the dignitaries which are virtually joined. So kindly participate in the inauguration with the lighting the lamp.
Lighting hai kuch.
Nothing can dim the light that shines from within. Let light shine out of darkness. Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that. Thank you so much. Now I request our guest of honor, Dr. Ishwar V. Basavareddy, sir, to kindly enlighten us.
ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। Most respected Honorable Vice Chancellor Dr. M.B. Patil sir, pranams to you, namaskar, and esteemed leader of our the Karnataka, and lead the entire BLD organizations for several years, which has got national reputation. And I do recognize the contribution of our Patil sir from our childhood. We have seen the progress of the contribution of the entire Patil sir family for the education in that part of our state. And today's guest of honor, Honorable Vice Chancellor of the university, Dr. Biradar sir, namaskar to you. And today's president and dean, Dr. Arvind Patil sir, and our esteemed colleague, Professor Das sir, and Professor Sumangla madam and other colleagues, and my esteemed colleagues here in my institute who are witnessing this virtual inaugural ceremony, and all the student friends of both the institutes. I namaskar to you all. I heartily welcome on behalf of Ministry of Ayush, Government of India, and also on behalf of my institute, Morarji Desai National Institute of Yoga. Today is a very auspicious day, in my opinion. The dream comes true, and it has started around 2.5 years back, almost when I visited the university for a conference. Then we have a series of discussions, and we have planned to start a collaborative center there, and almost we have finalized it last 1 year. Because of pandemic we have late, otherwise it might have started in the month of March, April. Now come to the I will not take much time. I want to listen to Professor M.B. Patil sir and his vision.
Today is your domain. We want you to hear it.
But yes, first of all, I will emphasize 3-4 things. Ours is a national institute, the only one government organization in the entire country, leading, taking many policy decisions in the promotion and development of yoga. And for your information, sir, we collaborate with leading medical institutions. After my joining in 2008, first of all, I started my MOU with NIMHANS. We have published more than 17 research papers, and now with our initiation, now it has a separate integrative medicine, yoga and integrative medicine center. They got 7-8 post got approved, and now it is an independent department. This was our initiative, has started in 2007-8 when Professor Nagaraj was the director, and my esteemed friend Professor Gangadhar now is the director. He was the head of the department of psychiatry. So now after that, we have started in JIPMER, DIPAS, AIMS, and all government organizations, since we are a government. But first time we are having an MOU and collaborative centers with a private university. And I found it is because of the potential I found in the faculty and the scope of work in that part of the country. And most importantly, Satish partner, who was our esteemed friend, he was with us in the Dr. Manchanda is one of the famous cardiologists. He worked for the one mega project on cardiac rehabilitation. So therefore, I proposed, why don't you start some advanced center where the university can got the national recognition and international recognition. And Professor Biradar sir is very kind enough. We spend a full one day, Professor Das and Professor Patil, Arvind Patil sir, and many of you are faculty member. Whole one day we discussed and finalized, let us start one at one center. But it took 1 year here to get the MOU signed. I have to answer many queries raised by the ministry, why you are going for the private organizations and like this. But this is my land, my hometown, and I would like to at least contribute. I will be here for another 3 years, and I should see that the center should flourish. And because it has the potential. Only thing is, such things are not coming in the national scenario. So now we come from this very small town, we are here. And the same thing, the big institutions are doing, but the institutions like yours, they're doing wonderful job, but they are not coming in the limelights. So that's why I would like to emphasize that the whole team shall work. It's my job to bring it to the national scenario, the research work being carried out. Now, the most important aspect is we would like to have a three important functions there. One is we have taken cardiac prevention and rehabilitation. So there we can work, that is the priority. And my institution is the WHO Collaborative CC, Collaborative Center in the, this is the only one center in the entire world for traditional medicine yoga. We have come up with a very standardized yoga protocol. Now the protocol developed by us, our institute, is going to have an app where it is nearly in the next 3 to 5 years, we want to reach some 200 crore people with that one 45 minutes yoga protocol. So like this, whatever the work done, we have to take into stock and have a, only thing is we are very good in yoga. We have a laboratories here, but I saw your laboratories, it's wonderful. Then with the facilities available there and the yoga expertise in our institute, we can do wonders. Therefore, immediately we can start up very, very small research projects, pilot studies. Then we can take up a 1 year or 2 years or 3 years long studies. For your information, when COVID pandemic has started, immediately in the June, I started one pilot studies for the healthcare workers and nursing staff, etc., one yoga protocol. So in a control group, we have 150, and in a experimental group, 150. So there, in all the cases, we taught yoga for 28 days. None of them has got the COVID-19. They are working hand to hand. That means first-hand contact with the COVID patients. The second 150, so out of them, 11 have got the COVID, though they are taking the various preventive measures of Ayurveda, then even modern medical sciences. But yoga helped half an hour morning and 15 minutes, and it was well developed with a proper ratio, very scientific basis. Myself practiced it for 3 months and advocated it. So that means yoga has the potential. Now we are taking a on that pilot project of within 3 months, we are taking a big project with a DSRT. So money is not the problem in the central government, really. But we need outcome-based research projects. So next project I'm taking about the, so 90 lakh rupees project on common yoga protocol in various centers. If your center is interested, we can start it from January itself. So that also, for cardiac rehabilitation, small projects we can start. That is the major area, but you can identify some of the thrust area there. There, I think so, some arthritis patients, and what are the asthma patients, if they are in big number, we can start some thing. For that one, we can start the awareness programs, cardiac rehabilitation camps, etc., which will bring the awareness, because this awareness will bring the importance. That's the one thing. But already in the last 15 days, once we signed and you decided to inaugurate, we have a meeting with the head of the department and the Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir. I already put forward to my finance committee, and we got sanctioned for 15 lakh rupees for the staff, and it will go to the governing council, and next 1 month I will get it done. So once we start the research projects, and I will see that some other funding agencies like DSRT and CSIR and all these things will get the funds. So again, I reiterate, fund is not a problem. The outcome-based research projects we are planning, and it is going to be one of the best center for the cardiac rehabilitation. In AIIMS also, we are working together, and we can have a collaborative seminars, both AIIMS and whatever you people, because you are all specialists in cardiac things. So many people in Delhi are very eager to collaborate with us. The third, first one is center, second one is the thrust areas and rural camps, etc. That also to the help us. And most importantly, the educational research. Now I am a national institute, and I hope so, with the grace of God, within few months, our institute is also going to be deemed to be university status. So we have already applied, the process is on. And two deemed universities may do wonderful collaborative programs. Now we have developed a PG diploma for yoga therapy for medical and paramedical graduates. So because we need now more than 10 lakh yoga professionals, we need to take yoga to the look and corners of the country. At the same time, we need the consultants. We have only BNMS graduates, and many medical graduates have few knowledge, but I have developed 1.5 years, very 1 year, very good diploma. Now we have a national MCI, that means NMC, I have requested to get it approved. So once it is get approved by the NMC, and it will be a recognized diploma where they will get the graduates. So meanwhile, I've already started this one. My course has been started yesterday. And if you take the interest, even 5 people or 10 people, some of your graduates or postgraduates who are doing, if they join there itself, we can have a virtual classes are going on. So we can jointly start this course. That will enhance the future possibilities of starting PG courses in yoga. That will provide you a lot of manpower and scope. They can take some dissertation work, etc. Like this, there are many possibilities are there, and it is to be realized so that our association will continue. So last but not the least, it's very emotional when it is comes to the motherland and our institution. We have saw, and always it is we attached with heart. Then if anything happens good there, and it gives a lot of happiness. That happiness, I think so, will bring with this center. And from next week, I'm maybe visiting my hometown, Dharwad, and if possible, I will come there for one day. We can plan and start these, even COVID-19, immediately the protocol what we have developed, we can start from this organization. And we'll fund it. The yoga instructors or therapists will provide immediately. That's not an issue at all. So that in that part of the country, the institution can take a lead. With these few words, I once again thank on behalf of my Honorable Minister, Shripad Naikji, and he might be very happy to inaugurate it, but he is busy, and I have not contacted even my secretary and my joint secretaries. I will inform them about the center they have. Very happy to know the center is being inaugurated by Honorable Vice Chancellor and our renowned leader, Dr. M.B. Patil, sir. Once again, I thank you very much, sir, for the all the initiative taken by the university. I flagged 3 points, and I think so, the faculty and the coordinators of the center will take it forward. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Together we can do wonders by integrating yoga with modern science. We can improve, we can in this part of North Karnataka, together we can bring health, harmony and happiness. Thank you, sir, once again. Now I request our Honorable Vice Chancellor Dr. M.S. Biradar, sir. Now I request our chief guest, Dr. M.B. Patil, sir, to say a few words.
Namaskar, everybody. I'm very happy as Chancellor of BLD University on this occasion of inauguration of Advanced Center of Yoga for Cardiac Prevention and Rehabilitation. First and foremost, I should thank and be grateful to Dr. Ishwar Basoradiji, who has been instrumental and for this center to be started. So I could hear from him the vast knowledge he has, the experience he has, and the passion he has for yoga, and the works what he has done throughout the country, as well as could hear him from his this one that he developed, this one in Nimans also, which is very important. So accordingly, his love for the motherland also should be really noticed and should be appreciated. So Ishwar Basuradiji, with your guidance and your support from Ayush Ministry and from Moraji Desai Yoga Development Center, we look forward not only in cardiac rehabilitation, in other things, as you were talking about, I could hear that arthritis. As you know, Vijaypur or Dharwad or any thing in North Karnataka or in Indian women, if you see particularly, their lifestyle of they being at home and cooking and all this, every alternate woman, mothers, my sisters, they all develop this arthritis problem, what I can see. So similarly now with this corona, which is there, has been spread so much, and it is as it is a lung-related thing and all. So I think yoga plays a very vital role. Yoga had been tested, our great heritage of our country, a traditional this one, wherein it can prevent, it can play a major role in prevention of all this diseases. So with this, I congratulate the Vice Chancellor, the principal, and we have our Kushal Das Ji, who has been a great asset to us, guiding from the various one, and he recently had been to the Dean this one for Life Sciences of UNESCO. It was a proud moment for us, Basuradi Ji. So with this, we will take this forward, and with all support from our side and commitment from our side to develop this yoga center, not only for cardiac, this one, we will identify key areas I have mentioned, which are relevant there in our area, and we'd like to address that through this yoga center. And again, I'm grateful to you for your help and to establish this center. It is your baby now. So we will all together nourish it. We'll all support it. As Chancellor of BLD University, we have always given the department's free hand with all support, whether it's financial or human resources, everything. That will be done by us. So, Basuradi Ji, I'm very grateful to you to associate, as you said, the first time with a private university. And that too, with our university, the backward area in a rural area, I'm really grateful to you. And I'm very proud of your, this one, that you have been so much attached to the motherland and the love for it. And we definitely, I promise you, we will take it forward. We'll make it one of the excellent centers in this part of Karnataka. With these words, I wish this yoga and Advanced Center for Yoga and for Cardiac Prevention and Rehabilitation Center to not only restrict for this cardiac rehabilitation and prevention and rehabilitation center, It will go into other key areas which are relevant in this part of Karnataka, and we will take it forward. I congratulate once again all of you, and most importantly, Dr. Ishwar Basavara DG for getting this center in our institution. I'm grateful to you, sir. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. And other key staff also who have been associated with this, who are instrumental in this. And I'll congratulate all of you for doing this great work. And we'll take it to the next level in the near future. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you very much, sir, for your support. Now I request our Vice Chancellor, sir, Dr. M.S. Biradar, sir, to say a few words.
President of this inaugural function, Principal and Dean Faculty of Medicine, Dr. Arvind Patil, Chief Guest, and my respected Chancellor, Dr. M.B. Patil ji, and another Chief Guest, and Director of Morarji Desai Yoga Sciences, New Delhi, Dr. Ishwar Babuji, sir, Ishwar Basavareddy, sir, Professor Das, whole Department of Physiology, and those who have logged in on the for the program. Good morning to all of you. It was in the year 2016 when Dr. Basavareddy visited our institution for Physiology National Conference, when we were chatting together with group of people and exchanging what we are doing in our respective field. He told that yoga science is one of the branch which is leading in the country. And recently, before 2 years, our esteemed Prime Minister declared it as a Yoga International Day, which was accepted by whole world. On that day, we decided to take this program to a logical conclusion. And today it has come in practice. And really, I'm really happy to express my thanks to whole Department of Yoga Sciences in New Delhi under Dr. Basavaraj, Ishwar Basavareddy sir, and his team, and my team, headed by Principal and Department of Physiology. Thank you, sir, for your all contributions which made us, our dream come true on this day. And as we know, health is a byproduct of both physical, mental, biological, and spiritual. Yoga has gained its own importance in many ways, and particularly the situations like COVID, the modern day stress, and the occupation which the people are moving from one part of the world to another part, and at the end of the day, they will be exhausted and they will not be able to maintain balance between these four ways of maintaining their good health. And definitely, I believe yoga is one thing which can kindle the spark to maintain our health in a steady level, so that morning to evening, we can maintain our balanced mind with the balanced physical as well as emotional health together. It was one of the project which was given by CSIR under the ICMR in 2018 to our institution. And we conducted under Physiology and Medicine and published it in various journals, international journals and national journals. And that has brought many credit to us. I do remember Dr. Satish Patil, who was doing work on that one, Dr. S.S. Patil, who was partner for that, and guided aptly by Professor Kushal Das, endothelial dysfunction and the correction of this dysfunction in a post-MI patients admitted to BLD hospital. And that program was a grand success, and publications came in so much so good journals that the credit went to yoga sciences as such, and yoga science has become popular in this area of Karnataka and South India, and you are one of the responsible person for that. From that day onwards, we are trying to establish many divisions of yoga in our own university, and as you said, it was difficult for you to convince the government agency to make a MOU with private universities. I do agree with you. We had that tough problem when we have MOU with the IIT Kanpur. Then still we are lingering with having an MOU with the Human Genetic Lab in Bangalore, which are run by government. There are many statutory and as well as regulatory authorities which were going to control that one. But you have made us, given us a boosting dose by sanctioning, getting sanctioned this center for our university. Definitely we keep in mind your efforts and your visit to our center, which you are told that next week you are going to plan, that we are awaiting for that visit. And we will show you how we have planned for the future progress of the center and making this center one of the best center in South India. And with your hand only, we want to see that it is established, move forward with the goals and objectives which my faculty has kept in this campus. With these few words, I once again thank you for all the efforts you have put in to make our dream come true on this day. Thank you, Anana.
Thank you, sir. Now I request today's president, Dr. Arvind Patil, sir, Dean Faculty of Medicine, to say a few words.
Honorable Chancellor, sir, respected Dr. M. Patil, sir, the moment for the day, Dr. Ishwar Basavareddy, co-director Morarji Desai National Institute of Yoga Center, New Delhi, was instrumental in getting this center, and his passion to grow, as suggested by our Chancellor, this part of Karnataka, I'm sure, with a very young, dedicated team, led by Dr. Sumangala Patil, very ably assisted by Jyoti, who will be the coordinator, and the other department staff, Pallavi, then Sri Lakshmi, Lata, CM Kulkarni, then the other people, Gaur Banu, all sure, with the grace of Dr. Das sir, we will definitely do well. And we assure you, sir, we work very hard not to disappoint your choice of choosing BLD University, and the government will also appreciate and open their mind so that the private universities can give an opportunity where a lot of infrastructure as well as a lot of the mood for the chancellors and vice chancellors to grow and make their university on a national and international forum. Surely it will be appreciated with the efforts of our dedicated team. And as you have suggested, sir, I'm sure we would definitely take it up in other diseases, respiratory ailments, particularly following COVID. We already started a COVID rehabilitation center in a small setup with your involvement. And when you visit our Bijapur in next week, definitely we'll take your guidelines and support. Since you already planned the protocols, we would definitely implement those so that this part of COVID patients also get their rehabilitation so that they don't have long-term ill effects of the COVID. So, and as our Chancellor said, the arthritis is a very common problem here. We see after 50, the productivity of our Indian woman is coming up very low because of their pain. Not only productivity, they go in agony of pain. So we look forward from them rehabilitation at the early age so that the prevention of arthritis can be done. And I'm sure this all can be done parallelly. We initiate with cardiac center. Definitely, we will be parallelly introducing because we have wonderful staff in the institution. And our dream of Chancellor and Vice Chancellor to build a good infrastructure in our own institution, which will be realized by introducing the other elements of human diseases, which can be yoga, can be brought. And it will be a proud moment for our Prime Minister also to see the center. We will definitely work hard, sir, to such a that where the Indian call for the International Yoga Day, where BLD will be part of in the South India too initially, and we work hard in that contest. And we really appreciate, sir, it is because of your support, and we look forward hand-holding for at least few months. That means the concept of Ayush, concept of yogic sciences, how it can be taken. And with your support regularly, I'm sure Jyoti will take up a lot of initiation, and it will be well supported by Sumangala and team of physiology, by ably guided by Dr. Das sir. So I'm sure we will not disappoint you, and we'll be a model for the world to be a center of excellence in yogic science. With this, once again, I humbly thank you very much for giving us this opportunity. With your support, we will definitely grow, sir. We will definitely work very hard to bring the system. And I am very thankful to my chancellor, who gives us a very, very supportive role for all new branches. He would never say no to any of these things. It is because of his support and ably enough support from the institution by our vice chancellor, we are able to grow in such a short period. The institution is slowly going towards a national level and international level. I'm sure it adds a lot of responsibility to work hard, sustain the changes and bring more quality changes, and more important, to be a model for others. This university should work in that context. With the founding father's vision, we definitely work on those angles. And I sincerely thank the Department of Ayush, Ministry of Ayush, as well as you, sir, in particular, who has taken this lot of efforts to make this institution a center for yoga. With this, I thank all of you for giving us this wonderful opportunity, and we look forward for a good, excellent yogic center in this part of Karnataka, sir. Thank you, sir.
I forgot to mention the name of our former Vice Chancellor, Professor V.G. Mulimani, sir. He was instrumental in bringing Basavareddy to our campus and introducing him. All the while, every month he was asking, what is the status of your MOU with National Morarji Desai University of this one. And he was asking today morning also, whether Basavareddy has helped you or not. Sir, I have conveyed positively that he is your student, and we will be his student for establishing this Yogic Sciences Center in our university. Thank you for that. Thank you.
Sir, also I want to acknowledge, and also Satish, I think so now he is in another college, but he has also instrumental. And I thank Professor Mulimani, sir, for introducing there itself, sir. Thank you. Unmute कीजिए. Unmute. हाँ, yes.
Thank you, sir, for continued support and kindness. Now it is the time of vote of thanks. I deem it a great honor and privilege to propose the vote of thanks on this memorable occasion. Let me first of all start by giving glory to the Almighty God for making today's occasion successful. First and foremost, I thank our chief guest, Dr. M.B. Patil, Chancellor BLD deemed to be university, for gracing this occasion. I am deeply humbled to extend heartfelt thanks to Dr. Ishwar Basavareddy, Director, Morarji Desai National Institute of Yoga, for support. I owe special gratitude to Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir, for continuous guidance and encouragement. I express my heartfelt thanks to today's chief guest, Dr. Arvind Patil, sir, Dean, Faculty of Medicine and Chairman, for his kindness and continued support. And also I thank my mentor, Professor Kusal K. Das, sir, and all the inviters, and all the staff of Morarji Desai National Institute of Yoga. Thank you, one and all. I thank IT department for extensive support. Without them, this program was nothing. So thank you very much for the IT department. Thank you, one and all, for gracing this occasion. We'll stand up for national anthem.
Janaganamana Adhinayaka Jayahe Bharat Bhagya Vidata Punjab Sindhu Gujarat Maratha Dravid Utkal Vanga Vindhya Himachal Yamuna Ganga Uchchal Jaladi Taranga Tava Shubha Naame Jaage Tava Shubha Aashish Maage Gaahe Tava Jaya Gaata जनगण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
थैंक यू अनन्या
Thank you, sir.